And well, let's quickly move on to yet another edition of the special lockdown questions broadcast on Republic TV this afternoon. Today, we have two special guests joining me, two eminent cardiologists, Dr. Ranjan Shetty, the head of Department for Interventional Cardiology at Manipal Hospitals in Bengaluru. A big thank you, doctors, for joining us this afternoon. Our viewers will be dialing in soon to put out their concerns, their questions, many questions really waiting for you this afternoon. Another caller calling from New Delhi, Ish Seth calling from the National Capital. Ish, go ahead with your question. Dr. Shetty will be taking your question.
Okay. Good morning. Good afternoon, doctor.
Go ahead, Ish Seth. We can hear you.
Sorry. Hello. Hello.
Yes, yes. Go ahead.
Hello.
Yes, doctor.
Yeah, yeah.
Doctor, good afternoon.
Please go ahead. Yeah.
Doctor, I have problem of heart and I have stent in my heart. And the second problem is that I am suffering from fibrosis peritoneal.
Okay.
And I'm here in India from last 3 months, actually.
Okay.
I stay abroad and there I am taking this medicine which is called aspirin for and bisoprolol.
Okay.
And rizobactin.
Yes.
Statin. And for my fibrosis peritoneal, I am taking prednisolone, 20 milligram. So I would like to know, do I have to take any precaution during this coronavirus?
Yeah, I think what's very important is you need to continue all your medicine. There is no doubt about that. All your medicine, including aspirin, the beta blocker, the cholesterol, and even steroid, what you are taking for fibrosing peritonitis should be continued. The precaution what you need to take is just like the precaution which everybody should take. You should try to avoid getting COVID. That means you should practice social distancing, should not move out unnecessarily. Even, you know, if there is some family member of you who needs to go out regularly, I think you should even practice social distancing from them. If possible, you should try to stay away and maintain distance. Because the medicine, there is no doubt, all medicines which people need to take, all heart medicine, all non-heart medicine which people need to take. They should not stop any of their medicine for the fear that if they get COVID, it's going to be more dangerous. It may not be true. In most of the condition, they have to continue all their medicines.
All right. Let's quickly move on to our next caller, MD Iqbal calling from Jammu. Dr. Shetty will be answering your question. Go ahead, MD Iqbal. All right, we seem to have lost that connection, but if I could take a quick question from Dr. Shetty himself. Dr. Shetty, you know, we were talking about... All right, I think we have the caller back with us. MD Iqbal, go ahead. Your question to Dr. Shetty, please.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
Hello.
Yes, we can hear you. Go ahead.
Mr. Iqbal, please go ahead.
Yeah, ma'am. Darsa, namaskar. Hello.
Namaskar, namaskar.
Darsa, main heart ka patient. Ji, main Darsa, pata kya hai? Mujhe matlab aise jab main sota hu to mujhe kaan mein awaaz aati hai matlab palpitation ki. Iske liye maine Darsa echo kiya, ECG ki, usme echo mein 75% heart jo hai function kar raha hai. BP bhi 120 aur 130 ke बीच में रहता हूं मैं नॉर्मल टिक्की खाता हूं 5-7 साल से बीपी की तो ये डॉक्टर साहब जब मैं बीपी चेक करता हूं तो मेरी 100 पल्पिटेशन रहती है जो है ना ये तो कान में आवाज आती रहती है जब मैं सोता हूं गैस्ट्रो का भी मैं मरीज हूं डॉक्टर साहब 20 साल से गैस्ट्रो गैस बनती है मुझे इसका डॉक्टर साहब मुझे ये इससे डर लगता है ना ये जो हार्ट पल्पिटेशन होती है ये क्या है
ओके ओके जो भी आपका हार्ट रेट है आपका हार्ट रेट तो थोड़ा हाई है नॉर्मल से थोड़ा हाई है पर ये कभी-कभी ये ना आपको थोड़ा एक्सरसाइज की कमी की वजह से भी हो सकता है तो अच्छा होगा आप रेगुलर एक्सरसाइज करें थोड़ा वॉकिंग ज्यादा करें इसके लिए वी एडवाइस ये उतना सीरियस बीमारी तो है नहीं है आपके लिए बीपी आप कंट्रोल करिए हाई इंटेंसिटी इंटरमिटेंट हाई इंटेंसिटी एक्सरसाइज बोलते हैं इसका मतलब आप दो तीन मिनट आप नॉर्मल स्पीड पे चलिए, एक मिनट बहुत तेज चलिए, फिर दो तीन मिनट नॉर्मल तेज पे चलिए. ऐसे हाई इंटेंसिटी इंटरमिटेंट एक्सरसाइज करने से हार्ट रेट थोड़ा कम आता है, थोड़ा योगा मेडिटेशन करने से भी हार्ट रेट कम आता है. ये उतना सीरियस बीमारी नहीं है, रेगुलर एक्सरसाइज करिए, हार्ट रेट अपने आप कम हो जाएगा.
Yes, no matter what, everyone has to follow the basic preventive measures. Social distancing, hand washing, covering your face, not touching your face. That's the basic that everyone has to follow in and out. Next question to Dr. Shetty. This one coming from Chennai. Vijay Kumar calling from Chennai. Go ahead, Mr. Vijay.
Yeah, hello.
Yeah, Vijay Kumar. Yeah.
Hello.
Mr. Vijay, we can hear you. Go ahead.
Hello. Yeah.
Hello.
Hello. Yeah. Yeah.
Hello. Sir, I am Vijay Kumar from Chennai. Hello.
Okay, Vijay Kumar. Yeah.
Sir, I went on 2016. I had a bypass surgery for 3 blocks. So simultaneously, I had some infection on that.
Okay.
Then they have given antibiotic. Everything they recovered. Then after 1 or 2 months, again I got an infection in kidney, and creatinine level increased to 5.5, and they have given some dialysis for 8-9 dialysis. Afterwards they revived. Now it is 2.32 creatinine level, but every month I will go for checkup. But this month they have closed the OP. I cannot go out. What can I do, sir? What measure you are suggesting me?
Okay. This, I think, a very good question. If the person is stable and if he's on regular checkup, these are the times, if possible, you should avoid visiting hospital, because most hospitals, OPDs are closed now. Plus, also going to hospital where there is likely to be crowd, then there is chance of spread of infection. So most hospital now have option of video consultation and video electronic form of consultation and video consultation. We at our hospital also have opened a video consultation. So I think people should utilize this video consultation, which are available in most of the hospitals. If the question is only discussing a report and, just explaining your symptom, then probably this is the time not to visit your hospital and try to do it by using media now. Either you can email your doctor or email your hospital, do some teleconsultation or video consultation. Even what we are suggesting most of our patients is to, even if your surgery is elective, we are trying to postpone those elective surgeries also. So most hospitals are now running more emergency care, which includes both COVID as well as non-COVID emergency. The routine procedures are being postponed. So I should thank the Government of India here, which has allowed now video consultation for doctors. It was a very rapid approval which was given. And thanks to this, most hospitals have started video consultation with almost all their doctors.
A big thank you, doctors, for speaking to us this afternoon, taking all of those very important questions, addressing those concerns, taking your time out and joining us on this particular broadcast. We leave it at that. But thank you, and also a big thank you for serving us in this time of crisis. Thank you.